Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello guys, in this particular video we will learn the low frequency response of particular type of transistor amplifier, that is BJT amplifier. Okay, so we will concentrate on BJT amplifier in this particular video. So suppose I have a single stage amplifier, the circuit diagram will look like. So your circuit diagram is such that this is a voltage divider bias configuration, and basically here the change is I'm applying input here and I'm getting the output over here. Let's suppose the resistance, load resistance, is applied over here, right? So in the last video we have learned the simple RC network with which we will get to know that what is low frequency cutoff and what is high frequency cutoff. So basically in this particular low frequency response of BJT amplifier, we will have to learn what will be the value of the capacitor and what will be the value of the lower cutoff frequency according to these three capacitors, so that my amplifier will work and after that beyond that particular frequency of low cutoff, that is FL. Okay, so let's start with particular value of low cutoff frequency that I have to find out. Okay, so for that I require the AC analysis. Okay, so all these low frequency response we will get to know once we understood the DC analysis, because DC analysis is the first step, and after which we will jump into the AC analysis, and after that we will learn the frequency response. Okay, so let's have a look at the AC equivalent model of this particular circuit. Okay, so we'll learn this is nothing but your BJT amplifier circuit, and we will learn what will be the AC equivalent model. We'll say that I know the AC equivalent of this particular BJT is nothing but, let's suppose I have any kind of model you can take. You can take RE model, you can take RPi model, you can take H parameter model. Everything will be same if we are calculating for the low frequency cutoff. Okay, so let us start with the, let's say, RPi model. Here I have a transistor. Now in this particular AC equivalent model, I will first draw the AC equivalent of the transistor. Okay, and then I have to move further without any short circuit of this capacitor. We have to learn that how many RC circuits we will be getting. So if you look at this particular circuit, we'll get to know that this capacitor and these two resistance forms a first RC circuit at the input side. Second RC circuit will be getting if I take this particular resistance, which will be looking from the capacitor side, and this particular capacitor, I will be getting the value, I will be getting the another RC circuit that is using the emitter resistor and emitter bypass capacitor. Now at the output side, I will also be getting this RC will be connected at the AC equivalent model, will be getting RC connected to the ground, and RL also connected to the ground forms in another third RC network. So from that RC network, we'll get to know that obviously in all the RC network, we have the C which is in series and R is in shunt, and this is the type of the low frequency analysis, right? And here we have to calculate the value of FL. Okay, so let's move further without disturbing the capacitor, right? So we will draw the capacitor along with the resistors as well. So we will say that this is resistance RE, okay, along with the capacitor. Okay, at the input side we'll be having the resistance, that is Thevenin's resistance formed by R1 and R2, that is RB I can say. Okay, and here I can say that this RB is nothing but R1 parallel R2. Okay, moreover I will be getting one capacitor and one series resistance. Okay, so here we'll be having input VI. Here this resistance is R signal. Okay, and this capacitor ka namakaran is CC1. This is the input side without disturbing the capacitor in the network. Next is we will draw the output resistance RC, which is also connected to the ground. Then again one CC2, that is output coupling capacitor, along with the load resistor, and that is nothing but your VO. This is RL. RL is connected to ground. Okay, now what we'll have to learn, we will just concentrate on this particular part. We'll just concentrate on this first part, we'll just concentrate on this second part, and we will concentrate on this third part. Okay, so let's move from this 1, 2, 3. We'll get to know that each and every RC circuit is associated with lower cutoff frequency, and each and every lower cutoff frequency will be having different than that of another one. Okay, so let us have to calculate the value of lower cutoff frequency for each and every RC circuit in this single stage BJT amplifier. Okay, so let's move towards the calculation of lower cutoff frequency at the input side. Okay, so let us see. A at input. So we'll draw the circuit over here just for RC circuit, nothing else. And here we'll be getting the RB, I can say parallel to R pi. Okay. And I can say this is nothing but your CC1, this is R signal. As we have got that, in your RC network, what is the frequency? Frequency, let's say FL1 here we have got for input side. So FL1 is nothing but 1 upon 2 pi RC, right? We have studied it in simple RC network ka low frequency cutoff, and that is nothing but 2 pi RC, where only R is, if only R is present, then I can say that RB parallel R pi in your BJT amplifier single stage circuit. But if R signal is also available, source resistance is also available, then we'll have to learn something differently, right? So if you learn this considering the fact that this is your output resistance and this is your input resistance, and if you find out the ratio of VO1 divided by VI1 and follow the same procedure for low frequency cutoff, you will be getting the R is nothing but R signal plus this complete resistance. Okay, so I can say that here this R is nothing but R signal plus RB parallel R pi, right? I'll give you a simple trick after looking at each and every RC circuit in this particular amplifier network, and then we'll get to know that what will be the value of FL1, FL2 and FL3 in very short span of time. So C is nothing but CC1. Okay, as far as numerical is concerned, CC1, R signal and RB, R pi, everything will be given to you, but you have to calculate the lower cutoff frequency, right? Now, as far as input side is concerned, we finished the input side. Looking at the input side, we concluded that RB parallel R pi plus R signal is nothing but the value of R, and this capacitor is nothing but your input capacitor, that is CC1. So from that we'll easily be getting the value of FL1. Okay, so we'll move towards the next part, that is nothing but at output side. At the output side, we'll get to know that what will be the value of this particular FL. Okay, so we'll just draw the output side and we'll be easily getting what will be. Now low cutoff frequency value will be same, 1 upon 2 pi RC. Here just we'll have to decide that what will be the value of R and what will be the value of C. Simple. So here I can say that if you solve this again using the output and input method using lower frequency response, then we'll be getting that R is equal to, so in this particular circuit we will be getting the R is equal to RC plus RL, right? If load resistance is absent, we don't have to consider load resistance. If load resistance is present, we have to consider the load resistance by just adding the load resistance along with the RC. Okay, so this is the value of R, and simple, the value of C is nothing but CC2. Okay, then we will move towards the last but not the least critical topic, that is C part. Bypass capacitor side. Now in this particular side we will not only have to consider the emitter resistance but also have to consider some resistance which are connected to the emitter side as well as that particular capacitor. So we will say that this is your resistor R pi, this is your RB, and which is connected to the resistance RE. Here I can say the capacitor is placed. Now looking at this particular circuit, we should get to know that my aim is to calculate the value of resistor at the emitter side, not at the base side. So what we'll have to learn that in this particular circuit, if we look at this particular side, right, this is obviously, this is CE, right, and this is the R which we are looking into the circuit, and then we'll be getting whatever value we'll be getting for the resistances that we'll have to consider as the value of R. Now just look at this particular circuit, you'll get to know that this RB and this R pi is in series, right, and the current flowing through this RB and R pi is IB. Current flowing through this RE is nothing but IE. And obviously one current source is given over here, that is GMV pi, because of which we will be getting different value of the current IE flowing through the value of resistance RE. Now we'll have to calculate the value of the resistance looking from the capacitor CE, right? We'll just open this capacitor CE and we'll find out the value of the resistors which are remaining in this particular circuit. We'll get to know that RB is in parallel, is in series with R pi, and the whole combination RB R pi is in parallel with the RE. But here the fact is IB and IE are not same. So what we'll have to do, we'll have to shift the resistance at the emitter side. We'll have to shift these two resistances at the emitter side. So how can I shift that resistance to the emitter side? This is because I can say that IB, I can convert it into IE. I can say that this IB is equal to 1 IE, IB is equal to IE divided by 1 plus beta. Or else I can say that it is nothing but IE divided by 1 plus HFE, because HFE is nothing but the beta. Okay, so here I can say IB is equal to IE divided by 1 plus HFE. It means that I can say current is flowing through the RB plus R pi divided by 1 plus HFE, or divided by 1 plus I 1 plus beta is IE. So if we say IB is converted into IE divided by 1 plus HFE, I can say that I will take this part of 1 plus HFE along with the resistance part so that voltage drop will be same, right? So we will move further. I can say this particular resistance will be nothing but RB plus small r pi divided by 1 plus beta or 1 plus HFE, right? And along with this, RE is in parallel. So I will be getting the value of a resistance. I can say that R is equal to RB plus R pi divided by 1 plus beta. Here you can write HFE as well. And in parallel with RE. This is the value of R, right? And what we are looking for? We are looking for the frequency, low cutoff frequency, whose value is 1 upon 2 pi R into C, where R is this, and C is nothing but CE. So simply, we will be getting three values of the 3 RC circuit in single BJT, single stage BJT amplifier. Now, the question arises, which particular frequency we have to take as lower cutoff frequency, right? So I can say that lower cutoff frequency is nothing but the maximum value of FL1, FL2, FL3. So out of these three values, whichever value is maximum, I will have to consider this as low cutoff frequency. Question arises again, why, right? So I'll answer this. Let's draw the simple frequency response considering the fact that FL1 is less than FL2 is less than FL3. I have taken in a random manner. So it's not a hardened fast process that FL1 always and always will be less valued. So let us have this particular frequency response at the lower side, and I have got the value of this is FL1, this is FL2, and this is FL3, right? If we take FL1 as this particular, FL2 as, and FL3 as this. So, as far as FL2 is concerned, this will be like this. FL3 is concerned, this will be like this, okay? If I take FL1, then that will be, considering the fact that FL2 and FL3, for these circuits, these two RC circuits, the gain will be very, very less. If you consider this, then one of the gain is very, very less. If you consider this, then I will be getting the highest gain at that particular frequency. Okay, so only we have to consider the high frequency as your lower cutoff frequency, right? So, as far as low frequency response is concerned, we have calculated the value, went through the procedure of the finding the value of FL1, FL2 and FL3. But as I told you, I'll give you the trick regarding calculation of R, how to calculate the value of R very quickly, okay? If you have any complex circuit, then we have to understand that, take the capacitor, take the aju-baju ke resistance, sum it up, right? So R signal and RB, we have RB parallel R pi we have, and we'll just sum it up, right? Similarly, here we have RL and RC, aju-baju ke resistance, take the summation and we'll get the value of R, and that is the critical process with which we have to deal with, and then we get the exact value of FL, right? So stay tuned for Ikeda videos, learn more and more Ikeda videos with me. Thank you so much.